hold on tight. The new update of my amazing LEGO Spiderweb Rig add-on for Blender is now available on Gumroad and the Blender Market. And let me tell you, it's a big one, with lots of new features and improvements that will make animating easier for you. Before I show all the new features, I would like to thank all the previous supporters who got my add-on and left me feedback, reviews and ratings. Thank you very much. I really appreciate it and look forward to all the animations that are still to come. Okay, now for the update. After you have downloaded the new version, the first thing you should do is remove the old version. To do this, open the preferences and look for the spiderweb rig under add-ons and click on remove. Then click on install and select the new version. And don't forget to activate the whole thing. As before, the interface can be found in the end panel. The first thing you'll notice when you add a web rig is that there's a small note saying that you have to select the web rig layer if you want to access the controls. You can either do that here or you can click directly on the rig. The first big change compared to the first version, which I presented in my release video, is the option to change the color. Here you can choose completely freely how the web should look. By default, it comes in the white color value that the white LEGO bricks and Mecha bricks also have. The option to change the color came with the last update that I published, but since I didn't make a video for that update, I definitely wanted to mention it again for anyone who missed the last update. The same is true for the next change, the high quality switch that has also changed slightly. While in the first version of the add-on you had to activate HQ on each web rig individually before rendering, now the switch only affects the view within Blender in the viewport. If you want to render your scene, the high quality version is always used automatically, even if HQ is not activated. So you can work carefree with the low quality version, which runs much more smoothly, and you don't have to remember to change everything again before rendering. While we are on the subject of the high quality version, I can also show you what has changed in the appearance of the web. Both the plastic material and the cord have been completely redesigned. Here you can compare it with the old version. The plastic is no longer completely smooth, but now has the typical little bumps. And the cord not only has a new texture, but is also completely rebraided. The old version had a braid pattern made of 3 strands, which made the cord look somewhat flat. I thought the original LEGO cord used this pattern, but after looking into it more closely, I realized that it is actually a braided pattern made up of 6 strands. I recreated this with geometry nodes, which wasn't complicated at all and didn't take long at all, and I didn't have to watch countless tutorials and use countless mathematical functions that almost drove me crazy at all. And I definitely didn't spend nights dreaming about braid patterns. Well, after these, as I said, very simple changes, the cord now looks much better than before and is much closer to the original. The resolution slider still changes the resolution of the individual strands. What's new is that if you set the slider to 0, you get a string with no strands at all, saving even more performance. Recommended for webs that are further in the background and therefore only visible in small sizes. Scale is completely unchanged and continues to adjust the size of the web rig. With a size of 1, the rig fits on LEGO models from Mecha Bricks, which are also at a scale of 1. Now we come to the biggest changes, a completely new category with advanced settings. The first option here is fixed handle distance. This allows you to change the way the web behaves when you change the length. By default, the handles are on average the same distance from each other. What this means is that their distance from each other constantly changes slightly as you change the length of the web until a certain threshold is reached, then a new handle pops up in the middle of the string and the whole process starts again. This had the advantage that the web looks right in every frame and the handle distance are as close to the original LEGO web as possible. It does have the disadvantage, however, that every time a new handle pops up, the whole web twitches briefly. When fixed handle distance is activated, the way the handles appear changes. There is no longer an average distance, but a constant one. The new handles do not pop up in the middle, but at the end of the string. This has the advantage that the animation no longer twitches, but the disadvantage that the web at its end can differ significantly from the original model. So use this option as it best suits your scene. I would say that if you can see the beginning and the end of the web together in your frame, then it's better to leave the option off. But if the end of the web is not visible, you can get better and smoother results with the new option. Next, you can easily show and hide individual parts of the web. Very useful if you don't want to use the rig for a Spider-Man animation, but for something else and you only need a normal Lego cord. Or if Spider-Man is supposed to shoot several webs at once, like in this scene from A1 Animator. Now there are a few special settings for the cord. If you look at the old version again, I had made a semi-transparent cover around the cord. The reason is that the original Lego cord also seems to have a cover made of reflective plastic. At least the one from the most recent Spider-Man set that I own and that I used as a template, the Daily Bugle. When I dug around a bit, however, I found several cords from older sets that I own, where this cover is far less noticeable. Rather, it looks like a thin coating that makes the cord reflect the light. They are probably nylon cords, I guess. Since I like this look better, I also applied it to my web. If we switch to render mode and select a different HDRI for the background, you can see the differences more clearly. There is the option to set the coating in the string material itself. If you use Blender from version 4.0 onwards, this option is activated by default. In lower versions of Blender, I didn't find the look so convincing, which is why a mesh-based coating is activated by default. So, a very tight cover around the individual strands. You can see for yourself which look you like better. You can also switch both on together or switch both off. Then the string looks more like a string made of natural fibers and not like nylon. Note that the upper option naturally uses a lot more hardware power because it adds additional geometry. There is also an option for displacements in the material. I don't know how useful this is, but it allows you to emphasize the individual fibers of the strands even more. I'm exaggerating here with the value of 5. You can use it, but you probably don't have to. Only a few things have changed with the mother flash. I've adjusted the position so that it is better placed directly in front of the hand than in the old version, as you can clearly see in this comparison here. Connect to hand is now called attach to hand and works much better. In the old version, the handpiece didn't quite land in the right place with move to hand, and the rest of the web rig was pointed in the wrong direction. In the new version, the handpiece now sits perfectly on the hand and the three joints are also aligned correctly. Only the end piece stays behind, which makes sense since you don't want it to move away from the target. It's also much easier to let go of the web. There is now a simple let go button. It works in a very similar way to the dynamic parent add-on. When you press a button, the required keyframes are automatically created so that the web stays exactly in the right place. If you later change your mind about where you want to leave the web, you can do it like this. First, delete the keyframes that were created by the let go button. Then click on move to hand again. At first, the web is not sticking to the hand. There is a small reparent button that only appears in this special case. Click it and everything will work as it should, and the web and the hand will be connected again. Then there are a few small adjustments to how the web behaves when it is bent. In the old version, it was relatively easy for clipping to occur, so the cord was sticking out through the end pieces, which could only be prevented by scaling them up. In the new version, the web can be bent much more without clipping. With retracted joints, for example, it didn't work at all in the old version. In the new version, this is no longer a problem and the cord always comes out of the right place. Connect to target is now called attach to target, otherwise nothing has changed here. You can connect the end piece to a target and then move the web with it. For the sake of completeness, a quick word about the web curve, which you can use to draw your own webs in edit mode. Of course, it has also received all the visual adjustments, and if you select the web controller in the modifier properties, you can now switch the individual elements on and off, adjust the quality, change the material, and so on. I hope you like the update. If you have any other suggestions, please write them in the comments. If you want to know how to build a large Lego city with Blender without your computer exploding, then check out this video. Thanks again for your support. Feel free to subscribe to the channel and I'll see you in the next video.